Next question.
Hi. I'd love to know more about the production of Barry Lyndon, because I know in a sense it had to be salvaged from the remains of Napoleon, but for me, it's one of the best ones ever made.
Yeah, and what is your question?
I
agree with you. It's a wonderful film, yes. What I didn't quite get it. But you're talking about Barry Lyndon.
Yeah,
okay. Yeah.
In terms of the process of achieving that, how did it go about? How did you get to the point where you felt?
Do you mean, what part do you mean, how did we get it? This was a location film.
In terms of achieving as a production, like, at what point did you get really confident about the production? Because of obviously the disappointment that came about with Napoleon.
The disappointing about Barry Lyndon was the general audience reaction. Many people found it boring. And again, it's a film that was very, very successful in the Latin world and in Japan. The film was huge in France and Portugal and all this, but it didn't do well at all in England and in America, which is, of course, very sad because that's 50% of the audience for an English-speaking film. The film is totally made on location in Ireland and in England. A lot of second unit stuff in it. In that montage, you saw one little clip, which was Potsdam. It was, at that time, East Germany. You know, it was an incredible experience for me to negotiate this. You know, they were worried it was the film had anti-communist propaganda, and I don't know what. But we finally made it, when we got permission, it worked like clockwork. A big tricky thing was the candlelight photography. That, at that point, the film was very slow in speed. The standard lenses were F2. There was no faster lens for cinematography. And Stanley found this lens in a magazine which was developed by Zeiss for satellite photography. But I think I explain all this in my documentary. I don't want to now tell you this long story because maybe you know it. But anyway,
Everyone watched the documentary.
Oh yeah, well then I don't have to tell you that. Right. So it was a big production, yes. It was a long haul, and it was disappointing from a commercial point of view. Copper Orange was a huge success, Full Metal Jacket was a huge success, Barry Lyndon was not. Although many people think it's the greatest film that was made by Kubrick, but it doesn't help, you know.
Well, thank you very much. If we can move on to the next question. I'm very conscious of time.